Get up, stand up, show up is the theme for the 2022 NAIDOC Week, a nod to the community staring down and challenging racism.
The Indigenous Committee organising the celebration hopes it's a way to galvanise a genuine commitment to change from the whole community. With Arthi Mann, John Paul Janke is the co-chair of the National NAIDOC Committee as well as host of The Point on NITV and joins me now. Welcome to Weekend Breakfast.
Good morning, coming to you from Ngunnawal country here in Canberra.
Wonderful to have you along. Tell me about this theme.
Well, the theme, as you've just pointed out, is get up, stand up and show up. And there's some layers in that which we're asking the whole of Australia to celebrate. Look, importantly, what we want to do is this year marks two significant anniversaries, the 50th anniversary of the Tent Embassy and the 30th anniversary of the Mabo decision. So part of the NAIDOC theme really is about celebrating and honouring and maybe even learning more about those key moments and individuals who throughout our history have got up, stood up and showed up for change for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander communities. And they go back from the frontier wars to our earliest resistance fighters and to a lot of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people and communities who are standing for change today. And of course, our communities have a really proud history of getting up, of standing up and of showing up. And we continue to this day to show up. And as I said, look, there's two key anniversaries this year, Tent Embassy 50th, the Mabo decision 30th, but we want all Australians to learn more about those key moments, whether they be, you know, the Wave Hill walk-off, the Torres Strait Maritime Strike, the Pilbara Strike, the Wick decision, the Noonkanbah stance, the Redfern Statement. There's so many key moments in our history where our mob have got up, stood up and showed up.
Mm. Yeah, you're packing a whole lot in there, and it strikes me that part of the nuance of this theme is that it can apply and probably does across industries, be that media where you yourself have been making waves right through to politics, to business, to sport. Behind you, we can see trailblazers there, Cathy Freeman and Nikki Winmar. Is there a universality of this theme of what you've tried to achieve here?
Yeah, so part of that, as I just said, is really highlighting those individuals who have stood up in their own disciplines, in their own sectors. And we now have lots of people doing that across multiple sectors. And part of that, the theme is also a call out to move just beyond acknowledgements. We want real change in this country for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. And in its base form, the relationship between the wider community and Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. So we want a change in that, and we want to maintain the momentum towards change towards that. So we're asking people to not only, you know, get up, stand up, show up for change, but to support black businesses, support black artists, support creative artists, buy black authors, read black stories. You know, there's so many, as you're saying, so many achievers in all the different sectors that I think now is the time to really support and show your commitment to them.
And as part of this, there I'm sure will be people watching around the country this morning wondering where they go to get information on NAIDOC, on all of those historic challenges that you mentioned, but even there to find businesses that are owned and run by Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people to be able to give that real support and know that it's that their money is going to where to support real business, real Indigenous business.
Yeah, look, there's lots of ways you can support Indigenous businesses. You can go to Supply Nation on the web. You can also go to the various state and territory Indigenous Chamber of Commerce, and they have black business finders. Of course, social media plays a big part in the way that our mob are doing business, and there are owner-operators and small merchandise companies operating through social media, so searching for those. But that is a real tangible way of supporting, you know, Indigenous communities and supporting Indigenous businesses. But we're also asking people to support our artists. You know, buy black music, listen to black musicians, read black stories. I think more than ever before, there are more black authors, from academics to individuals who are writing black stories, which are really challenging and contesting and in some way changing the history of this country that a lot of us were taught going back generations. And I think that's the future. We've got to learn about the past to be able to move forward.
Well, and speaking about the past, at least the immediate past, the COVID-19 pandemic has knocked around your plans, for the NAIDOC committee's plans for events in recent years. How are you feeling looking towards this year? Do you think that you'll be able to re-host your big national awards gala?
Well, fingers crossed. We're hoping that by July, a lot of the COVID numbers around the country have dropped a bit, and we're able to operate in some sort of normal capacity. We haven't had a NAIDOC Awards for 2 years, so we're looking forward to an awards in July in Melbourne. Melbourne's our national focus city and the host of our national awards ceremony in July. So we're looking that we're able to host that event. But of course, we'll work with the local Victorian NAIDOC committee and traditional owners and key stakeholders in Melbourne to watch the situation as it unfolds. And it's a reminder to all of us that are working towards NAIDOC across the country, and there are lots of state and territory Victorian NAIDOC committees and local committees who do such great work to build events, to build gatherings that people can come and celebrate. And they work each year noting that they want the best for their community. They don't want to make the most vulnerable in their community be able to get COVID or be, COVID to have a possible outcome in our community. So we work a lot to make sure that we look after our communities. The other thing about this theme, of course, is we're inviting Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander artists to enter the NAIDOC poster competition. So if you're 13 and above and you're an Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander artist, enter the National NAIDOC poster competition. Your artwork could become the artwork on the most iconic poster in Australia, the NAIDOC art poster. 250,000 printed copies. It's distributed throughout the world. It's online, it's on buildings, it's on buses, it's on trams. This year it was even put on a gaming machine, a very limited edition gaming machine of 3 copies. So your artwork can really be the key to NAIDOC celebrations.
Yeah, outstanding. Look, thanks so much for joining us, National NAIDOC Committee Co-Chair John Paul Janke. Good to have you along.
Thanks, Dan.
Yeah, brilliant. Brilliant chat and good to see.
Yeah, and well,
what's ahead for NAIDOC?
As JP said there, yeah. Fingers crossed that everything goes well and over the whole, that national celebration, because it's been a couple of years without it.
Yeah, I don't envy anyone who is planning those sorts of big events at the moment. It must be a nervous wait.